Do you have an existing form you would like to turn into a JotForm board? Well, let me show you how. Hey JotFormers, welcome back. I'm Kimberly, and like I mentioned, if you have a form that you have been utilizing and it has submissions on it and you would like to turn it into a JotForm board, there are a couple of different ways that you can do that. So as you can see, I'm currently in the desktop version of my workspace. Now, the first way that we can do this is I'm gonna go ahead and click on any one of my forms, and then up at the top, we can see where it says boards. We can click here and it'll start that board creation process. We can even come over here where it says more, and in the data column right down here, we have create a board. Or in the top left-hand corner, we can choose to create, then come over to board, and we can select a form from here. So I'm gonna go ahead and choose this option. All of these options are gonna get you to the same place. And I'm gonna utilize my travel request because we can see it has 9 submissions on it already. Let's choose next. And we can see that it is pulling the name from my form into my board. It's giving me some pre-populated task groups. So if you would like to edit the names or the colors or even get rid or add a new group, you can do that here before the board is created. And then here we can import existing submissions. If you would prefer to not import them, just turn that off, super simple. So let's go ahead and choose next. And here's where we're going to map the fields for our cards. So first we have our title, and that's gonna be the name of the person who filled out the form. Next we have our due date, that's gonna be the departure date. Our tag can be the type of travel, and the description is gonna be their desired destination. And we can see right here, it pretty much filling everything out for us. Now over here, we can choose up to 5 things that we can have on our card. So for me, I personally don't need their email. I would like their destination, departure date, and their type of travel. So we can have up to those 5. So we see everything right over here. That looks good to me. Let's go ahead and create. And everything is gonna land in that backlog group. Now, one thing to keep in mind, if this is your first time creating a board, you're going to have some onboarding tasks from JotForm, just to give you an idea of how boards work. So if you don't want those, all you have to do is just click on the 3 dots and delete. And same with this one right here. Now from here, like I mentioned, all of those submissions are gonna land over in the backlog group. So if we want, we can go ahead and just start moving things over to different groups. And we can have one that's done. Perfect. Now we can easily add a task by clicking the plus sign here or even down at the bottom, and it'll give us a blank card to start filling out. We can choose these 3 dots here. We can rename this group if we would like. We can even change the color, or we can even import submissions just to this specific group. We can add a completely new group over here on the right. And we also have our board settings up here. This is gonna do similar things to what we just talked about. So under the task fields, if you want, we can edit those here. We can even edit like the due date, as well as the tag. Now, if you want, we can add a new field, even multiple choice. We can even add in the ability to have attachments and images within our board. But if I head back, we can look at the card view. So we can take things off of the card. I'm gonna go ahead and add them back because I like having everything on the card face so I can see everything at a glance. And we even have our theme here. So if you want, you can change that background, make it look more like you. You can even add in an image so that way it fits your brand to a T. So I'm gonna go ahead and jump on back. Now, if you have people who are helping you manage this board, you can easily share this board with them. In the top right-hand corner, we can choose to share. Right now, it's a private board. If you'd like, we can change the settings for it to be a company access board, and you can give overarching permissions to the entire board. But if we head back and we're gonna do it one by one, we can choose individual permissions per person that you're going to be adding. So if I X out of this, we can now take a look at our connected assets. So right now we have that travel request form. If we want, we can connect another form, or if you're utilizing an AI agent or have this form as part of a workflow, you'll see all of those connected assets right here. Now, one final thing is once you have all these submissions over on the left-hand side, you need to find someone. Let's go ahead and do a quick search to find someone. I'm gonna do a quick search for Lacey because she is right there. Perfect. Now we can also utilize the filter option. So if we click on filter, we can filter by some quick options. So assign to me, due next week, overdue, or we can utilize our fields to find specific things that we're looking for. And it really is as simple as that. If you have any questions about how to create your own board off of an existing form, let us know down below in the comments. If you like this video and you got some value, hit that like button and don't forget to subscribe and turn on the bell so you get a notification every time we put out a new video. I'll see you next time.